Today we're having a look at the evolution of music from Stone Age to now, from people who look like Jonas to now.
Let's do it!
Ah, yeah, Neanderthal bone flute. That actually sounds kind of sick.
I'll sing along to this.
Loads of flutes early on, apparently.
18,000 BC, now we've jumped 22,000 years. Not much have changed.
Then they found out about
They realized they could just remove the flute.
1950, Hymn of Lipit Ishtar.
Ooh, instrument.
How is this notated? This is so cool.
Yeah. I always think that much of the stuff, like languages and stuff that we find on old things, is just like us projecting, and it's just like random stuff. Someone's just like, yeah, this is a song right here. And it's like just bleep, blah, 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 blah. That's literally a toilet. Someone has a good point here. The problem with music archaeology is that only instruments not made of wood survive, no drums. Okay.
I love this.
Yeah, I wonder when this was recorded. Obviously not at 900 before Christ.
Hey, they had cameras back then.
Yeah, they did.
500 BC, nice.
It's so atmospheric, all this old stuff, I think.
Yeah.
It's like almost meditative. How surprising if it's like suddenly like, you make me feel like I'm living.
300 BC, dream. Yeah.
Is that what's it called?
The kazoo. This is the kazoo. Yeah. Ooh, we're off to Christ now.
Oh, there we go. Now every song is about Jesus.
Yeah. Considering we've been spanning 40,000 years now, not that much has changed.
I haven't heard a single 808. You know what I mean?
Is it the Indian drum
tabla
that kind of sounds like an 808?
Yeah, they're definitely like a sustained, like kind of subby noise. By the way, welcome back to another video. My name is Joel from RoomieOfficial. I'm here with Jonas and August, and we have a special treat for you guys today. The treat of love. Oh! Not that type of love, Jonas. Stop! Stop! Here we go.
Ooh, let's go.
Now we got a groove going. They invented the groove 1000 after D.
Aw, I miss the groove now.
Yeah, now once you have groove, it's hard to go back. These type of melodies are actually still in a lot of popular music. In like Spanish music, for example, you will hear the da, 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 da. I could hear that on like a
This is my jam. I love this.
I like this as well.
I like this hairstyle. That's what I want.
Kind of looks like a hipster. This is my jam. I grew up singing this stuff. No,
really?
For real. Yeah. I grew up singing in choirs. I love this.
So me and Jonas played this VR game for a while. The bow and arrow game.
In Death Unchained.
That game has a lot of music that sounds exactly like these recordings. And it's so atmospheric. It's like one of the best soundtracks to a VR game, at least.
You heard it here first, guys. 1560s was a good year for video game.
VR video game songwriting. 1560. Let's go. Let's go. But these people can't have looked like this.
That was like the ideal of that age was huge eyes. So they always enhance the eyes in these portraits.
I always thought that I had like small eyes. And then I did the Yosify thing with just like this ideal thing with your face. It keeps making my eyes smaller. Oh no. My eyes are too big. 1652. We have little pitches until I have you. You know this is special, yeah. That's beautiful. Well done, Lil Pitchy. I think that's actually still on Spotify, even though it's from the 1600s. Check it out.
Canon in D minor. Let's go.
No, wait, this is a ripoff of Maroon 5.
He clearly had a time machine, traveled to 2020,
yeah,
copied the song and went back.
Exactly.
Absolutely disgusting.
And now Adam Levine can't afford another body tattoo, and it honestly breaks my heart. Someone's like, Maroon 1605. That's applause. Oh, well done.
Oh, I've sung this so many times.
Oi, he stole Leonard Cohen's song?
No, but okay, true serious for like 1 second. Like, this is getting more like groove now, like different types of grooves and stuff. This is interesting. I don't know, but I think it's art. Mo's art. Okay. Oh, is that the same picture? In different qualities? Yeah, I mean, all of this is classic. The funny thing about this is, like, all of this is copyright free now, so you can basically just steal as much as you want from these amazing, amazing works, which is cool. Ah, oh, here we go. Beethoven. Or however you say that. Do you say Beethoven?
Beethoven.
Is he the one that was deaf?
Well, not all his life, but he wrote his last things when he was deaf.
Yes!
Very nice. Ah, that's excellent. Oh, this is lit.
He's Norwegian, right? Or was?
Is he? That sounds great. I feel like they discovered cymbals around this time.
I feel like they discovered turning up the BPM.
Yeah, that too.
Ooh, 1896. We're getting close now.
Yeah, yeah. It'll be real music soon, guys. Not kidding. classic. Now we get like ragtime stuff. Okay.
You're a grand old rag. You're a high flying flag. Actual recording.
It's funny because all the recordings have been so hi-fi so far, and when we get to the real recordings, yeah, it's like downgraded. It's like,
I'm in a can of soup.
So we're getting into jazz territory. This was really edgy back then, right? Because like people were dancing and like meeting each other, dating and stuff to the jazz music. People were like, ooh, immoral jazz music. No likey.
Song that hasn't been said before.
Ah.
Oh. This is epic.
Why does he look so freaking smooth?
Yeah, what the heck?
He's such a smooth man. Benny Goodman.
He's the inventor of face tune.
Yeah. That's beautiful. I read an interview with a composer of that, and he had that song for ages, and it didn't get it placed anywhere. And his other composer friend was like making fun of him. It's like, oh, you mean the Where song? Because he was like, oh, the melodic climax is on Where in Somewhere, and he thought that was cringe. Somewhere. It's like, oh, you're not getting your Where song placed anywhere? That's surprising. And then it became like one of the biggest songs ever. By the way, did you know that we have a Discord server for the community? You can hang out down there. I do meet and greets there. You can talk to me. You can be like, hey, Joel, why do you have an ugly mustache? And I'll be like, I'm sorry. If you want me to shave it, I will. And you'll be like, no, actually, I love it. I was just kidding. Head on over to Discord. You guys are amazing. Like, it's a really nice community over there.
I love these type of harmonies.
Yeah. Bing bong.
Still one of the top 10 streaming songs every year.
Yeah, that's true. Christmas. That's true. Feeling good this
morning, I feel like a... Oh, yeah, now the real groove starts. You women have heard of
jalapenos, you heard the noise they make. This is one of those genres that don't sit with me well. Just a lot of the old rock is so boring to me.
It will sound boring now, but nothing sounded like this.
Kids in the future are going to feel the same way about EDM music, like with the drops. They're going to be like, oh, this sounds the same. Ah, classic song too.
Yeah. Drift by
the window. He's got such a timbre.
Ooh, that's a nice voice, yeah. Yeah. Oh, it's happening.
Oh, yeah.
Iconic.
Getting, yeah. Gonna get grittier now. Oh, never mind.
I love this song though.
It is good.
Oh, so good too.
The voice.
Nice. Yeah. This riff I learned once.
Probably the most famous guitar riff ever, maybe?
Just because it's so easy, right? It's any beginner can learn it in like an hour. Oh, I love those like 70s backing vocals. It doesn't sound the same anymore, backing vocals. I don't know how what they were doing. Chorus or something? All of these songs are so good. All this 70s stuff is just so good. Okay, that's not that good.
I love that song.
No, you don't.
Here we go. Australia! Woo!
Like, as much as I love this, I feel like we're on our way now into the 80s of, like, the simplification of popular music, and it's gonna, like, become just simpler and simpler, right? Which is easier to remember, but it's not as fun to me. Come on, that's not a good voice. No one thinks that,
I love his voice.
Like a crazy train! That's what it sounds like. This is a good singer, I think.
Great singer. Shame about the stage moves. Here we got some good stage moves.
Ah, so good.
This is a bop.
So good. Oh. Such swag.
I forgot about this song.
Nah.
Yes.
This is a banger of a song.
Okay.
My favorite Madonna song here.
Not a great singer, great artist.
I like her on Like a Virgin because I'm not a fan of the voice, but they pitch her up so much in Like a Virgin that it sounds different. Dang, okay. This is like is this the birth of like metal as we know it? Kind of?
Well, yeah, they're kind of a predecessor to a lot of different metal genres.
Okay, yeah. Loads of metal.
So are Pantera 90s. As well. They're hugely important.
Yeah. Ooh, yeah!
This is hugely important for meme songs. Ooh, lit! Such a good hook.
Oh, yeah, let's go. Sweden! Ah. I've never... like corn.
Me neither. I'm more into other vegetables. Cucumber.
I was
pretty
gonna
good.
Do that, yo. Oh. Hey now, you're an all-star. Get your game on, go
play. I tried so hard and got it's very hard to say this is not good. Something people forget about Linkin Park is how well produced they are. They were like really early with like really producing rock music and like cutting up the drums. Like it was very much about the technicalities of like finding that middle ground between pop and that type of rock music.
It's just one of my legend bands.
Yeah. So different. Yeah. Iconic.
Ooh, this is my childhood.
I feel like Evanescence just copied Linkin Park.
I can see that. They just had another type of singer.
It's like the type of rap.
Wake me up!
I think throughout this whole thing, I feel like there's a lot of bands copying each other. Oh, this is so lit. People don't really talk about his voice as much as they should, I think. I think he's like so technically proficient and still got such freaking soul to his voice. And here's the singer who's got too much attention. I mean, they're cool.
He just has a good voice more than he's a good singer.
He looks good shirtless.
Never heard this.
What?
I have heard this.
This person who made this compilation obviously has a bias for metal. What defined music in 2008 was Slipknot, Psychosocial.
We haven't like had a single pure pop act since like 2000.
Come on.
This is it. Evolution from Mozart to this.
Oh, yeah. This song is great, though.
Yeah, it's a good video. It's a good song. At least we get to see
the evolution of music.
Yeah, okay. Okay, I'm gonna put $100 that it's a dude who made this compilation. As I say that, okay. I guess this was just so big.
Hasn't been a female artist for a while.
Oh, you're right. Interesting point from Shoebomb Dad once again. 2008 to 2009 production's quality improved massively. Sometimes I feel like things sound too good now. People spend so much time sound designing their music now. Okay. But yeah, Jonas, good point. Not a single female in quite some time now. Ah, come on. I'm a huge Jason Derulo fan, but come the fuck on. I'ma leave the door open. I'ma leave the door open, girl. That was the end of music.
We should pick one for 2022 ourselves.
Think Olivia Rodrigo.
That's a woman? Do women still make music?
I forgot after watching this compilation.
If you're supposed to select one female artist for 2022, it's either Dua Lipa or Doja Cat.
I would like to pick Doja Cat. So feminine with grace, I touch your soul when you hear me say, boy, let me be a
woman. Okay guys, if you feel like we missed anything, we actually made biggest song each year for 100 years. This video right here is more focused on like from 1921 to 2021. It's got more stuff in it that you might want to see, not just like metal and a bunch of men, a bunch of dicks.